This is what Kitten was meant to be. Kaboom! Thunder rippled through the dark night sky, shaking the earth with every clap and crash. Rain came down in torrents, each drop hitting the earth, making muddy streams speed down the hills and flood the valleys with cold, murky water. Inside the cottage, the farmer sipped a cup of hot, fresh, brewed coffee and peered out the window, watching the rain flow down the windowpane. "Well, the weatherman is right," he said to no one in particular. "It's definitely the storm of the season." Turning from the window, he ambled over to his favorite chair next to the fireplace to put his feet up for a while and read the newspaper. The fire was warm and crackling, and between his oh-so-comfortable favorite chair and his coffee, the farmer was just about to nod off to sleep when there was a bark outside the cottage door. The farmer eased out of his chair and walked sleepily over to the door. It creaked open, and sitting on the welcome mat was none other than friendly old Jethro himself. "Well, hello there, boy. What are you doing out at this time of night?" the farmer inquired. Jethro cocked his head, pricked up his ears, and let out a soft moo. "Why don't you go lay back down under the porch and get some sleep? You know the missus won't let you come inside when you're all wet." And with that, he shut the door, leaving poor Jethro sitting on the porch. Jethro whimpered and scratched the door, but the farmer was already snoring in his chair. "Well, I'll be," Jethro proclaimed. "Now what do I do?" He looked down between his front paws. The farmer had been so sleepy he failed to notice the small wet bundle Jethro had carried to the door. "I guess I'll just have to find someone else to help me." And with that, he picked up the soggy parcel and trotted through the rain to the barn. Leaping through the doggy door, he entered the warm sanctuary and in the darkness tripped right over Mr. Goose. Honk! The barn came alive with sound. Arf, ba, quack, neigh, moo, bawk! Feathers ruffled, noses snorted, and feet stamped, and all the barn animals awoke in a panic. "It's only me," Jethro tried to shout above the noise. "Jethro!" all the animals exclaimed at once. "I'm sorry," he said, setting down the bundle. "I didn't mean to wake everyone, but the farmer ignored me, and I didn't know what else to do with it." "Do with what?" asked Mrs. Cow as she yawned. Jethro nosed the bundle, and wrapped in a red bandana was a small, shivering, soggy, white, and orange kitten. "Poor dear," cooed Mrs. Horse. "Where on earth did you find it?" "It was under a tree by the frog pond. I looked all over for his mama, but couldn't find anyone." Just then, the little kitten sneezed. "Oh, Jethro, why don't you bring it over and set it in my nest?" came a soft call from the corner. Ever so daintily, he picked up the kitten by its scruff and slowly stepped into the dark corner towards the boys. "I've got plenty of room, and it will stay nice and warm under my feathers." Mrs. Duck slowly stood, and beneath her white plumage revealed six fuzzy yellow ducklings at home. Jethro eased the little kitten under Mrs. Duck, careful not to disturb the ducklings from their slumber. "Thank you, ma'am," Jethro whispered. "Don't worry about a thing here," Mrs. Duck said happily. "You go get some sleep, and I'll take good care of you." With a nod and a wave of his tail, Jethro opened the door back into the rain, and all the animals called goodnight to one another and settled back into slumber. "Cock-a-doodle-doo," called the rooster as the sun peeked through the barn windows. Mrs. Duck awoke to peeps and yawns as her ducklings aroused from their slumber. "Good morning, my darling," she said as she grunted. As she dreamed of her down white feathers. "Mama, mama," they cracked out, poking their fluffy heads out between long stems. Just then, a short orange face with white little ears popped out from under Mama's wing. "Meow," called softly. Mama Duck stood and stepped off the nest, causing the little kitten and the baby ducks to slide off her back and wings and then plop onto the soft nest floor. "Quack," squeaked one little duck, gazing curiously at the funny face. "Quack," squeaked another little duck. "Beep," trilled the littlest duck. One little duck walked boldly over to the kitten and stuck his nose right in front of the kitten. Cocked his head sideways and stared at the kitten's bright green eyes. "Meow," the kitten said. The bold little duck walked behind the kitten and saw his bright orange tail. It twitched this way and that way, back and forth, back and forth. And then he opened his beak and grabbed the kitten's tail. "Meow," the kitten cried out. The bold little duck jumped, quickly dropping the kitten's tail and ran to get behind his mother. "Oh," gasped Mama, "no, you do not bite his tail," she scolded. The little duck hung his head. "Quack," he said softly in apology. Your duck," came a call from across the barn. "Come along, darlings, breakfast is ready," Mama said and walked toward the farmer's call. The ducklings began following the mother. "Quack," peeped one little duck. "Quack," said another. "Peep," said the littlest duck. They all followed Mama out of the barn. The kitten stood and watched the ducks leaving the barn. "Quack," said the kitten, then scampered off after the ducklings. The kitten followed the ducks out the barn and into the bright, damp morning, where all sorts of animals were starting the day. A large black and white cow was waiting by the big red barn. Red chickens squawked and pecked and scratched the ground. Sheep bleated after little ones as they ran circles around their grassy pen. Mama Duck stopped at a long little trough filled with green yellow corn. Quack, quack, Mama Duck said pleasurably and began tucking at the grain. Quack, 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 the little ducks pecked happily. Quack, said the kitten as he stepped up to the grain trough. He peered at the yellow corn and watched the ducks pecking at the kernels, picking a kernel up between his teeth. He chewed and chewed and chewed and chewed. And then he spit the kernel back into the trough. The kitten yawned and stretched his mouth. The kernel was just too hard for him to chew. He looked hungrily in the trough to try another kernel, but the ducklings had eaten all of the corn. Mama Duck shook her tail and ruffled her feathers, then said, "How about a swim, darlings?" "Quack, quack, quack, quack," they all complained as they followed Mama across the muddy barnyard. Squish, squish, splash, the ducklings went as they crossed mud puddle after mud puddle. Splat, hop, splat, the kitten went as he followed behind the ducklings, avoiding the largest of puddles. At the edge of the clear pond water, all the ducks slipped easily into the cool water. "Quack, quack, quack," all the ducks said. The kitten stood at the pond's edge, sniffed the water, and scrunched up his nose. He didn't like the cold wet stuff that splashed his toes. But when he saw the ducklings gliding across the top of the water, he stuck his chin in the air, let out a confident quack, and marched right into the pond. Cold water crept over his toes, and then another step, it was up to his belly. A shiver rolled across his back. "Quack," he said confidently, then took one last jump into the water. He paddled and paddled, water splashing over his chin and getting his face wet. "Meow, meow, meow," the kitten cried out. Mama Duck turned and saw the kitten struggling in the water and sped over to him. "Quack, quack, quack, quack," Mama Duck screamed as she hurriedly splashed through the water to rescue the little kitten. The kitten was caught, coughing and spitting water when Mama pulled him and set him on her back. "Oh my goodness," she exclaimed, "you poor thing. What on earth were you doing?" Little kitten just shivered and let out a soft quack. Mama looked at the kitten and said, "You're a kitten, not a duck. Kittens don't swim." The little kitten just looked at Mama Duck and quacked. Mama sighed and took the little kitten to the edge of the pond where she set him down and fluffed his fur dry with her bill. "You wait right here while I get the rest of my baby," she said, and she paddled off back into the pond, leaving the kitten at the pond's edge. The kitten saw the other ducks playing and having fun, then hung his head and sneezed as one big tear rolled down his nose. "Quack, quack," he sniffled and started to lick his paws. Mama led the ducklings out of the pond, and they all followed her back to the barn, kitten trailing slowly behind with his head and tail on low. Back at the barn, the ducks sat lazily around, soaking up the warm afternoon sun when the farmer's wife walked to the big grain bin and began scooping grain into a big bucket. Mama and the ducklings followed the farmer's wife and looked at her with big eyes and quacked. "Oh, go away," she said, and waved her hands at them to shoo them away. Kitten walked around the side of the granary where he saw a small, brown, furry animal. It was a mouse. The little mouse walked behind the granary. Kitten followed. The mouse stopped, so Kitten stopped. Mouse looked at Kitten with black, beady eyes. Suddenly, the mouse ran to the front of the grain bin where the farmer's wife was busy scooping grain. Kitten leapt after the mouse as he ran right under the farmer's wife's feet. "Eek!" she screamed as she stomped her feet, then quickly jumped in the door of the granary. The ducks, startled by the wife's outburst, let out a tremendous quack, then flapped their wings, and quack, quack, quack some more, running around in a panic. Kitten chased after the mouse, going round and round and round the bucket of grain, faster and faster and faster, until the mouse dove off in a hole under the grain bin. "Oh my goodness," exclaimed the farmer's wife as she called out of the granary. She reached down and patted the kitten's head. "Oh my, oh thank you, sweetheart," Kitten purred and rubbed on the farmer's wife as she threw a handful of grain to the ducks. "You look absolutely famished," she declared. "I'm going to go get you a bowl of milk," and she marched toward the farmhouse. The ducks gathered around the kitten, pecking at the throat grain with claps and flaps of approval. Farmer's wife came back with a small bowl and set it in front of the kitten. He stuck his nose in the bowl and sniffed. It was creamy and warm and smelled really, really good. Kitten started licking up the milk hungrily. "Here, kitty, kitty," the farmer's wife called. A gray-striped cat came hopping over to the farmer's wife. Kitten stopped and stared. The gray cat had two pointy ears, just like Kitten. Big green eyes, just like Kitten, and a long, quick tail, like Kitten's. "Meow," said the granny cat, said the gray cat as she came over and started lapping up milk. "Meow," Kitten replied, then stuck his nose back in the bowl and drank up the rest of the milk. After Farmer's wife had taken the empty bowl and the ducks had gone back to enjoy the sun, Kitten followed the gray cat into the barn. The gray cat showed Kitten how to jump up the rickety old barn stairs and walk on a thin board, catch pieces of straw floating across the yard, and how to catch mice in the grain bins. Later that night, Kitten went back to the duck nest. "Meow," he said as he crawled in the nest next to Mama Duck. "Quack, quack, quack," said the duckling sleepily. Kitten purred as Mama Duck rubbed her bill against his head. "I'm glad you decided to be a kitten again," she said softly. "You're much happier when you're doing what God intended for you to." Kitten purred even louder in response, then slipped off into sleep. This day, if you peek in the big barn door at night, you can still find an orange and white cat sleeping with the ducks. And never again did Kitten forget who he was or try to become someone he wasn't. Because Mama Duck was right. You can't be a duck when you're meant to be a cat.